Let me start with this question. Who knows what is the bandwidth, how fast their production networks are? Yes, who knows? I've got 2-3 hands in a room of 30 plus people, all right? Now, arguably this thing matters. So how much data you can move through the network is going to have severe ramifications on the performance of your system. If it's gigabit Ethernet, if it's 10 gigabit Ethernet, that difference, it's 10x difference, is going to add up. So, but let's talk about what does that actually give you? Because the thing is, when you say the word gigabit, the average developer does sort of an instantaneous translation. Giga, ooh, that's a lot. So much that I don't need to think about it, hence effectively infinity. But the thing is, first of all, there's no such thing as infinite bandwidth. But let's talk about just gigabit Ethernet to give you a baseline. Gigabit Ethernet, what do you get from that? So first of all, understand, network engineers talk in bits, we developers talk in bytes. Right? They didn't say gigabyte Ethernet, they said gigabit. So gigabit equals 128 megabytes per second. All right? That's raw Ethernet. You put TCP on top of that, you're going to be losing about half. So out of the 128 megabytes per second, you're talking about roughly 60 megabytes per second. Throw in some serialization, regardless of which type of serialization, JSON, protocol buffers, whatever, you're going to be losing arguably another half. The bigger the serialization model that you're using, XML serialization, heaven forbid, obviously you're going to be losing a lot more. Use protocol buffers, you're going to be losing a lot less, but every time you're going to be losing something. So out of the 60 megabytes per second, maybe you're talking about 30 megabytes per second, 25, 40-ish, all right? Now, imagine, that's the highway that you've got. Now, you've got performance problems. What's the solution? I know. Let's put a whole lot more servers on the same exact network. That'll work, right? It's like, oh, I can't get home fast enough because of traffic. What should we do? Let's put 100,000 more cars on the same exact highway. In some cases, adding more servers is not going to help. It's only going to make things worse. So it's important to understand, out of that bandwidth, there are going to be constraints, and the more traffic there is, remember that TCP thing that we talked about over here, TCP packet retransmit? The more traffic there is, the more likelihood there are going to be network-level collisions that are going to require these type of retransmissions, which are going to slow things down even more. So when bandwidth becomes a problem, latency also starts to become a bigger and bigger problem. And if latency becomes a big enough problem, then you're back into timeout territory. And if you're in timeout territory, then you've got reliability issues. Right? So it's important to understand how these things connect to each other. Now, again, let's put these things a little bit in a historical context. 15 years ago, gigabit Ethernet comes onto the scene. All right? Around that time, we have processors that are doing a couple billion operations per second. Fast forward 15 years, now everybody's got a supercomputer in their pocket with 8 cores, where each of them can do a billion operations per second, all right? The amount of memory that we've got, again, go back 15 years, we used to be very happy if we could get a laptop with 2 to 4 gigabytes of memory. Nowadays, we're complaining that the new MacBook Pro doesn't come with 32 gigabytes of memory. Talk about storage. Amazon comes onto the scene with S3, a gigabyte of storage costs whatever it did, 5 cents. Nowadays, who cares? Nobody uses a gigabyte of storage. Are you joking? We're talking about terabytes and petabytes. We've got this big data thing where we're storing everything all the time forever. Storage is almost free. And during this time frame where almost everything else in computing has done 100x, 1000x, 10,000x, Network bandwidth has barely cracked the 10x in terms of broad deployment. So we have less bandwidth, relatively speaking, today compared to the amount of data that we're trying to push around as we did 15 years ago. And that's ended up being true for quite some time, that our demands for moving data around are growing much faster than the bandwidth that we have available to move that data around.
Hi, I'm Udi Dahan. I hope you're enjoying these clips on the fallacies of distributed computing. Click on the left to watch the next video, or on the right to go to the Fallacies playlist, or in the middle to subscribe to our channel. For more information, including the full videos from my course, check out the links below the video. Thanks, and see you next time.